welcome everyone to tonight's Battlefront. We are just a week or so away from our annual Super Series pay-per-view. Hello everyone, RJ Peckham alongside the broadcast colleague Mark Adams. And tonight, Mark, we are live here at the Jobbing.com Arena in Phoenix, Arizona. And I guess that would be an appropriate name for the Phoenix Coyotes, considering they're jobbing to every other team on the NHL roster. Tonight, though, we have some surprises in store for you, as we have gotten some confirmation that the Terminator will make his long-awaited return tonight. Also, we will see the primetime title being decided here on Battlefront, as Dracula, the reigning primetime champion, will defend his belt against Bane. And Bane is looking to add some advantages for his team for the Super Series, and winning the primetime title, I guess, would put insurmountable odds in his team's favor.
Billy Mays here, breaking your back, pounding, super strong, super strong. Now that's the strength of Billy Mays, guarantee. Super strong.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the new TWA Assistant General Manager, Billy Mays.
And we'll send you the lead with lightning speed. Just select a bit, then lock it low. Pull the trigger.
Quite the announcement last time on Battlefront, as it was revealed that Billy Mays is now going to be second in charge to rip up the Penny Bags. Therefore, Penny Bags can't just make decisions and spend money and frivolities all on by himself. He has to get absolute authorization from his partner, Billy Mays.
Just pee in a closet. It's that easy. And we'll send you the world's most powerful weed. And we'll send you the weed with lightning speed. Just select a bit, then lock and load. Pull the trigger, then lock and load. So you'll never have trouble claiming what's yours. Now that's the strength of Billy Mays, guarantee. Billy Mays here, breaking your back, pounding, super strong. Now that's the strength of Billy Mays.
I don't know what ideas or any creative ideas Billy Mays has up his sleeve, but maybe things will get interesting. He always rises to the occasion, as he did during his previous term as GM. I never thought I'd be asked to return, but I'm glad I was! It seems TWA is in another Trump phase, and it needs my help! Monopoly guy, whether you like it or not, I am indeed your assistant GM! And I'm here to make sure you are unbiased and make the right decisions. I'm already too late to stop you from going PG, but I'm sure Bond, Fox, and AAA will put an end to that at the Super Series. Oh, just introduce us already. Speaking of Super Series, here's Team Monopoly. There's Pennybags and his band of goons, led by Officer Mallory. Of course, Pennybags would love to have a feather in his cap should Bane defeat Dracula for the primetime title here tonight. Though I don't care for Rich Uncle Pennybags, I will say he has assembled pretty much the ultimate team. I wouldn't be surprised if AAA, James Bond, and Fox McCloud could be in trouble come the Super Series pay-per-view.
It is TWA World, my Super Series team that will defend my honor at the event. Officer Mallory, my loyal law enforcer, who has stood by my side all this time. Bane, the strong, brutal, and cerebral powerhouse of my deputy squad. and Batman. Bane's partner.
I have the utmost confidence in my team that I know they won't displease me. Alright, moving on, Mr. Mays. I believe you had an idea for tonight's main event. Yes, Jason Voorhees clearly wants a TWA title match with Freddy Krueger. But it sounds to me like Invisible Man wants one more shot at the title too. So I think our main event should be those two, Invisible Man, Jason Voorhees, in a number one contenders match. And the winner will meet Freddy Krueger for the title at End of Days.
Very good, Mace. You stole my idea, but that's why it's a good one.
Hey, Monopoly guy.
I swear I will fire the next person who calls me that.
I was just made aware that I would be defending my belt against that fellow tonight.
Yeah, what about it?
Oh, I just wanted to deliver my pre-match I'm going to win speech. You may look big and scary, Bane, but do you know who else looks big and scary? Frankenstein. And I defeat him for this very title at Time Frame. No offense, Frankie.
I am not a slow-minded, lumbering collection of corpses, Dracula. Remember that. Spare me your confidence-boosting speech. It's not words that win titles. It's bone-crushing moves, like the ones I possess.
You're putting me to sleep. I'll head to my coffin for a quick nap. Then we shall do the dance of combat.
Dracula does not seem intimidated by Bane at all. And really, why should he? He did defeat Frankenstein to win that coveted primetime title, and he looks like he's more than ready to take on the challenge of Bane. But what does Bane have in store for the primetime champion? We will find out later tonight. Coming up, though, we are going to have our first match of the night as the Barones, after being tossed around like rag dolls by Jagat last time on Battlefront, are going to take on the universal monsters, Karras and Frankenstein. Now the Barones, they got a lot of spirit going in as a team, but they have angered the wrong people in recent weeks, and I don't know if they want to piss off Karras and Frankenstein, as they are going to team up with the Invisible Man at the Super Series against Freddy's Men.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Germany, weighing in at 299 pounds, Frankenstein's Monster.
He looks bigger and badder than ever. Frankenstein, he's ready for combat at the Super Series. Frankenstein, alongside Karras and the Invisible Man, both feel that they have been pushed aside by the future generations of horror stars, namely Freddy Krueger and his slashers. So Invisible Man's team hopes to put Freddy Krueger and his new generation stars in their place.
And his partner, from Egypt, weighing in at 258 pounds, Karis!
This team is aptly named the Universal Monsters, but they have also been former Universal Champions. Frankenstein won the Universal belt back in 2012, whereas Karis won the Universal title earlier this year at Telethon 5. Both men had unforgettable runs with the belt. These two former rivals, now partners. And their leader in command, the Invisible Man, is going to be gearing up for competition of his own as he is set to take on Jason Voorhees.
And their opponents, accompanied by their mother, Marie Barone, from Long Island, New York, at a total combined weight of 411 pounds, Raymond and Robert Barone.
Before I was interrupted by the Barones, I would like to reiterate that the Invisible Man and Jason Voorhees will go one-on-one later on tonight on Battlefront to determine who will be the number one contender for Freddy's TWA Championship match at the next End of Days pay-per-view to close out the year.
Oh, speaking of closing out the year, I would like to mention to everybody how Yukinori Taniguchi screwed me over.
What happened this time?
Oh, him and his brilliant, the brilliant people that he partners with at 2K gave me a contract for 2K15, but the extremely huge catch to it was that I'd have to lay off 75 of the people on our roster. That's right, a 25-man roster. That's the lowest number we've ever had in like 15 years.
Well, I'm pretty sure Rich Uncle Pennybags will give the green light to make that move.
I'm gonna see to it that does not happen, even if we have to stay with our 2K14 contract.
I don't know how you can get a hold of Yukinori Taniguchi. Doesn't he appear mostly on TWAR events?
Oh, I will get a hold of him, just like I did at that stupid event that we were at where he tried screwing us over.
Meanwhile, Robert is trying to toss Karis across the ring, but looks like Robert's cockiness is getting the better of him as Karis is now hammering knots into his head. Oh, Raymond tried to get into Karis' business. Big mistake. Of course, Raymond and Robert both have an equalizer in the form of their mother, Marie, at ringside. There's not much she can do against Karis or Frankenstein physically, but she knows how to use her mind to ensure that both her sons walk away the victors. Of course, she wasn't at ringside when both Ray and Robert got crushed, manhandled, and basically man-raped by Gigant last time on Battlefront. Frankenstein with a huge backbreaker on Robert Barone. And I don't see how Ray Barone's gonna fare any better if he gets into that ring. Oh! Ray doesn't seem scared though. There's a hard fist. And now Robert's gonna allow Raymond to try Frankenstein on for size. And Robert holds Frankenstein for Raymond to poke him in the eyes. Come on, ref. That was a bit of an illegal move. And now we're seeing the double team come into play. Oh! Ray's got to the count of five to get out of the ring.
I'd just like to add one more thing. Hold on.
That's a brain chop!
Use the pin.
But, oh, of course, Marie was going to save the day for her son. What if Freddy Krueger starts laughing at the idea that Frankenstein and Karis both got their butts handed to them at the hands of the Barons? If the Universal Monsters can't beat the Barons here tonight, then the Universal Monsters team is going to look pretty bad come the Super Series.
Okay, now I'll speak. To any of you wrestling game fans, especially ones like me who like to create stuff, do not waste your money on this piece of game. 2K, Yukes, whoever the hell is in charge, they've screwed you over again. I'm not wasting my money on it. You shouldn't either. Now I feel better.
Okay. Karis, he's just observing the corpse of Ray Barone. I don't know why Karis didn't go for the pin when he had the perfect opportunity to do so. Well, it looks like Karis was just playing possum, toying around with Ray Barone some more, and now Karis going high risk. That's unusual. Karis is a big man. He usually stays with a ground and pound offense. And Karis with a deadly throat vice, and Raymond must have suffered whiplash to the neck as a result of that. Here's the pin. One, two, three. Frankenstein and Karis are the victors.
You are the winners, the Universal Monster!
And Michael Myers and Leatherface the Slashers waste no time in beating up their Super Series opponents!
This had to be expected.
If it's going to be this bad here, I hate to see what's going to go down at the Super Series. Michael Myers and Leatherface, they are not fucking around. And now Michael Myers going for the chair, but... Hey, wait a minute! Here comes Invisible Man and Dracula! Invisible Man... Of course he's going to get his hands on them at the Super Series. Dracula just comes to the aid of his buddy. Wait a minute.
All right, enough of this. These back and forth sneak attacks are getting us nowhere. Super Series will be the end of this. Let's all save until then.
I agree, Freddy. But it will not be the end. I fight Jason tonight to receive the TWA title contention, which I will win. After Team Monsters defeats Team Slashers, our friends may end their involvement. But you and I will clash one last time for the championship 1 month from now. I can read you like a book now. I've studied your every move. I can beat you at end of days.
No! You can't!
And there comes Jason Voorhees hard steel chair shot to Freddy Krueger's back.
What was that you were saying about Invisible Man not being able to beat you?
And, ooh, hard shot to that head. Jason Voorhees put Freddy Krueger in his place right there. Invisible Man had some strong words, basically guaranteeing that he was going to go in against Freddy Krueger for the number one contendership to the title at End of Days. But with the way Jason Voorhees manhandled Freddy Krueger, if I were Invisible Man, I would stay a little bit more on my toes, like a midget at a urinal.
Open your ear holes, Jigot!
What?
I got a 20th Century Fox title match with that Dos Equis guy at Supper Series!
20th Century Fox title?
Oh, I don't know, it's that one with the globe on it!
So you gave yourself a Universal title match?
Yeah!
So you're allowed to win singles titles, but I can't?
Yes, cause you and Riggs are my lap bitches, and I can do whatever I wish. And I order you to order me a pizza, then soften up Dos Equis in a match tonight. No, beat them yourself like a real champion. How dare you? You will do what I say, what I say, how I say, what I say, what I say. Get to the point. Pointers, you disobey me. I'll send you straight back to TWAR, sauerkraut.
Fine, I'll fight him. But I'm just doing it to increase my streak, not to help you.
Okay. By the way, I want an extra large pepperoni with anchovies.
Why would you do that to Samus? Charles Robinson and I came to the conclusion that her laser thing is an illegal move. It was the right thing to do. Okay, fine. Maybe I could somewhat understand stripping her of the title. But why did you have to suspend her? Would you stop questioning my judgment? I'm the actual GM, not you! It is my job to question your judgment! Well, stop worrying. I got big plans for the woman's title. Yeah, you're probably gonna give it to Mallory, right? Well, considering Mallory's status as Pennybag's bitch, maybe the woman's title is not far off for him.
If Harvey Whippleman could win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the Television Wrestling Association, the Terminator!
But whose side is he on?
Well, we don't know for sure. Samus didn't make a promise to Superman that she had fixed the Terminator's CPU just before she was suspended. Of course, the last time we thought Terminator's CPU was fixed, he ended up attacking Superman more and basically being used as a weapon of mass destruction for Sarah Connor's perverted ideals on destroying the world. I don't know what Terminator's gonna say, or if he even is gonna say anything. I mean, with this new CPU, there could have been repercussions. He probably doesn't have much access information, detailed files. He probably can't even speak.
What does he want?
There's Iron Man, but I can tell he's on a bender again. Terminator was about to speak, but baffled by this turn of events. I don't know what Iron Man's business is with the Terminator. I mean, these two hardly even meet, and I just don't understand. Let's just hear what's going on.
Hey, God. I bet you think you did a great job, huh? You are a lousy Republicaner and a disgrace to America. Why don't you go back to the gym and come night and day? Oh no, I got a brand new idea. Listen to this. Listen. Are you listening? Let us fight right now. Chopper. Backyard brawl. Right here. Right here. What do you say, Freeze? Whoops, my fist slipped.
Oh! And now Iron Man just tackled the Terminator, and now Terminator is using his fists to beat the crap out of Iron Man. Now we got security trying to restrain these two, and it looks like, do we have a match? An impromptu match has now taken place here. It looks like it's going to be Terminator in his return match against Iron Man.
But if he couldn't beat Waldo, how's he gonna beat him?
Well, if Iron Man is that drunk and stupid to actually go to the ring and insult the Terminator, then he got himself into this, plain and simple. And Terminator just coming with those hard rights. Iron Man, he is all disoriented, as if actually, he was disoriented before this match started. But now, he's going to be feeling an even worse hangover come next morning.
Well, I don't know what's going to hurt more, his head or his whole body.
Terminator's bringing the pain, but we're still not clear on what Terminator's motives are, as he was about to speak but was interrupted by Iron Man, which has led to the match you see here right now on Battlefront. Iron Man, as we've documented, has been on a horrid losing streak.
It's safe to say he won't be making the King of the Tube tournament next year.
Well, we still got less than a year or so before we worry about that. The interesting fact to point out is both of these men were former King of the Tube winners. Terminator in 2011, Iron Man in 2013. So I guess maybe Iron Man feels he is the true king. That's the only insane, rational reason I can give for why he has decided to pick on the Terminator. Terminator, I think, took a little too much time before trying to nail an Irish whip, which allowed Iron Man to get out of the way. Nonetheless, Terminator has scouted him again and gone for the DDT. One, two, oh, very close. And now Terminator. Oh, massive choke slam. I thought he was going to go for the one hand. One, two. Iron Man is still kicking. Virtually, though, I haven't seen Iron Man get one amount of offense in this match. And Iron Man, he didn't even hang onto the ropes. And, oh, massive pile driver right on the concrete. Iron Man, he's got to be dizzy enough as it is. Terminator is showing no mercy against Iron Man.
This isn't a match. It's target practice.
That much I'll say. Iron Man, I guess, is going to live to rue the day that he stuck his nose in the Terminator's business. Iron Man, his eyes look glazed over like donuts. He's not getting up at all. Referee Charles Robinson making the count, but Iron Man, he tripped trying to get back up. He's disoriented. Finally gets back in the ring, but now I think the count has been restarted again, and now both men are back in. Massive spine buster. And here's the pin. One. Oh! I don't know how Iron Man keeps kicking out, but it can't last long. Terminator. Massive termination. Looks like Iron Man is terminated.
Here's your winner, the Terminator!
Big win for his return. Terminator came back bigger, badder, and stronger than ever.
Judging by that beating he gave Iron Man, now I'm really not sure whose side he's on.
Well, the thing to remember, Mark, is Iron Man brought this among himself. He decided to go into that ring and pick on the Terminator, so it looks like he had to defend himself. So maybe Terminator is back on the good side, but who knows? We'll have to check out in the next upcoming weeks.
I just don't know about this, babe. Would you stop being such a pussy and fight Arms? Jesus Christ! Don't you want that $30,000 bonus for winning the light heavyweight title? And besides, I thought you hated Arms. You should be begging for this match. Well, yeah, but Hogan said... I don't give a shit what Hogan said. You are fighting Arms, and that's... Hey, don't you push my girl. That's it, Legs. Get angry. He hurts your baby real bad.
Sounds to me like this gold digger wants my title more than you do.
Shut your f***ing mouth, Arms. She ain't no gold digger. You just jealous. Jealous that I've dated more girls this year than you ever have in your life. Wow. So you've never dated anyone in your life. How pathetic.
Shut up, bitch! I'd rather be alone than date a skank like you!
Oh, that's it, Arms. You're a dead man. Now I really am challenging you at the Super Series.
Yes! For the title?
No. For your bandana. Yes, the title!
I actually feel kind of sorry for you, old buddy. This siren has got you under her spell.
Something smells fishy about that whole Legs, Arms, Catwoman business. But anyway, here comes Bugs Bunny and Homer Simpson, who we actually saw cozying up to each other last time on Battlefront. And I really don't see this whole reasoning why Bugs Bunny and Homer Simpson are together. Both come from entirely different universes. Bugs Bunny's got the microphone. I guess we'll hear the explanation from him.
I know you Maroons had short attention spans, but you do remember what Jim... Oh, I'm sorry. East Ventura said a month ago, he said I was pissed off because he was a real person and I was just a lifeless drawing. Well, he was semi-right. I am upset that people like him, Chuck Norris, James Bond, Indiana Jones, Batman, are all looked after, while us drawings like Homer and I are treated like dirt. Yeah, but where he was wrong was how I feel about myself. I like me. I am a two-dimensional drawing, and I'm proud of it, Doc. My new friend, Homer, and I are both proud of who we are, and we want equality. We have banded together to form what we call 2B. Yeah, but instead of whining and complaining to get what we want, like previous factions, we're gonna fight for equality, beating superstar after superstar, until the TWA realizes that we are just as good or better than Chuck Norris or James Bond or Indiana Jones.
Your turn, pal.
Everyone laughs at the thought of me becoming a main eventer. Well, shut up! I can do anything I want if I really try. Banks and me will beat all of the spineless cockroaches you call your heroes until you have no choice but to take us seriously and call us your heroes. So who will it be first? We welcome any of you overrated bums!
Billy Mays here breaking your back. Pounding. Super strong. Super, super strong. Now that's the strength of Billy Mays guarantee. Super strong. Super, super strong.
I think it's you guys who have the short attention spans. Homer, you're a former tag team champion, and even a primetime champion. And Bugs Bunny, from what I hear, you held the tag team titles barely 4 months ago. What right do you have to say TWA has treated you like dirt?
What about our salaries, huh? We get paid diddly squat compared to the others.
Oh, for Christ's sake, how many times does this have to be made clear? Main eventers and title holders are paid more than lower card guys. That is how it is. It's because they're yellow, isn't it, you racist b***h?
Oh, I don't believe this.
All right, hot shots, you want rage and graces? Tonight, I'll put you in a tag team title number one contenders match. You win, you go to Super Series and fight whomever the tag team champions are. Then, you can win the belts, earn more cash, and shut the hell up, okay? In fact, I'm gonna find two guys so we can have this match right now. Wait right here.
Billy Mays has pretty much had it up to here with Bugs Bunny and Homer Simpson's complaining. And now he's going to bring out two mystery opponents for this team to fight to determine who will be number one contenders to the tag team titles.
These guys?
Well, Hulk Hogan, he's going to be going into the Super Series facing the most interesting man in the world for the Universal title. Whereas Legs, he's going to go for the light heavyweight title.
Yeah, did these guys forget they've already got work and they're going to put more work on themselves if they win this?
And there's a blind tag made by Homer Simpson. Bugs Bunny a bit confused, but I think he's going to let it pass. There's Homer with a clip. Also, I don't know how Legs is going to keep his head into the match. Or the light heavyweight championship match, for that matter, at the Super Series. Because he supposedly has Catwoman in his corner. But if I know that gold-digging vixen for what she is, Legs has to watch out.
Bugs can vouch for him on that.
We all know that Catwoman was the one that broke up the team of Bugs Bunny and Jim Carrey in the first place. They were reigning supreme as tag team champions when they were Cartoon Central, but then Catwoman came in and broke the two up, which caused them to lose the tag team belts.
Although personally, I think it was just because of how brilliant Kubrick trained Jack and Alex. That's why they won.
Well, if I were Stanley Kubrick, as well as Jack Torrance and Alex DeLarge, I'd be watching this match with great intent.
No, I'd be laughing at the thought of facing either of these teams.
Well, Homer Simpson and Bugs Bunny look like they're beginning to show a bit of continuity as a team. Bulk Hogan, on the other hand, he's just running. Bulk Hogan going high risk, and not even close.
In fact, I think he broke something there.
Yeah, if he's not careful, the guy's got to be like 150. Not to mention, he looked like he packed on more pounds through rice. I mean, has he been hitting the sushi bar all this time? Bugs Bunny with a unique Hurricane Rana to legs. Both Bugs Bunny and Homer Simpson were former tag team champions with different partners. So we'll see if their past tag team success can merge into one super team. Now, wait a minute. His leg's going to attack referee. That would have been dumb. Otherwise, the disqualification win would have been given to Bugs and Homer on the spot. Also, I think Arms is watching this match. And for that matter, maybe the most interesting man in the world.
If you're going to tell me that he has to watch it to study Hogan, I'm just going to laugh in your face.
Well, I'm pretty sure with the most interesting man, he's studying Hogan to find how a man this old continues to live in the TWA. Legs with a pin. One. Bugs was able to kick out. And legs with a hard kick to Homer Simpson. For that matter, what's happening with Gigant? I know he was asked to order a pizza, but is he going to come out at all to assist the team of Bulk Hogan and Legs? Homer and Bugs are in the driver's seat currently.
Oh, that's nice. You're losing, so you take it out on our table.
And now, Legs trying to bring the steel chair, which is completely stupid because he will lose number one contendership to the tag belts.
I swear Hogan's stupidity is infectious, and it's rubbed off on Legs.
Well, for that matter, wouldn't have rubbed off on Gigant too, considering he's part of the Rejects Rebellion?
Yeah, would you ever see him with those guys?
Bugs Bunny so far has scouted Legs pretty well, but now he's stuck on the wrong side of town. Homer Simpson is still left on the other side of the ring. Bugs Bunny being double teamed by Bulk Hogan and Legs. There's a double kick. Hogan cupping his ear to the north, south, east, and west.
But he can't hear them.
Probably needs his hearing aid.
Forgot his finisher again.
There's the all-timers kicking in, and Bugs Bunny goes for a massive fist to Bulk Hogan's cranium. which is becoming shinier each and every day.
What a dramatic tag by Hogan, but there was nobody there.
Bulk Hogan is so delirious at this point. Homer and Bugs Bunny, I think they could be posting on the way to the tag team title match at the Super Series. Oh, I will give credit to Bulk Hogan, though. He committed a power move against Bugs Bunny, which broke the steel steps. And Homer Simpson, he's not going to take too kindly to his new partner being attacked like that. Now Homer goes for the pinfall. Oh. Bulk Hogan was able to kick out. It was probably just a... And Homer Simpson with his famous simplex maneuver. Bugs Bunny knocks legs off the apron. One, two, three. 2D are the number one contenders.
You are your winners. 2D.
Well, Homer and Bugs pulled off a massive victory for their first match as a team. But are these guys going to be ready for a team as seasoned as the current tag team champions, the Krueger Congregation at Super Series?
Your weekly earnings, Jack. You deserve it. You're a great human actor. Thanks, sir.
Oh, yes.
What did Kubrick just give to Jack Torrance? What was in that briefcase?
Cash. The cash that these 2D drawings don't get.
I don't know if that's going to psychologically compromise 2D.
TWA World, may I have your attention, please? After giving much thought to the women's title situation, I have brought forth this idea that both Mr. Mays and I have agreed upon. At the Super Series, we will hold a mini 4-Diva tournament to crown two number one contenders. And those two ladies will face off at End of Days for the vacant women's title.
Yes, even though Pennybags never even should have done what he did to Samus. There's nothing I can do about it now, so we'll just have to crown a new champion.
I have not yet decided who to place in the tournament. So hurry on over, girls. The faster you speak to me, the better your chances of qualifying.
Mr. Pennybags.
Hey, most interesting man. I haven't seen you in ages. How are you?
Yeah, whatever, sir. If I may, I think Metal Green should be in that tournament. She is the hardest working diva on this roster, and she deserves this opportunity.
Why are you asking me this? Why is Metal Queen herself not asking me?
Oh, well, it's kind of a surprise for her, sir.
Oh, I see, you sly devil. You got the hots for her, huh? But isn't she still dating Imhotep?
You are really far behind, Billy. Anyway, can you put her in, sir?
I suppose so. Why not?
Gracias, Mr. Pennybags.
I guess she really has a thing for older guys.
Well, coming up next, we got the Primetime Championship to be decided as Dracula will attempt to turn back the challenge of the monster Bane. But why was the most interesting man so intent on giving Metal Queen a shot at the woman's title? Is this another attempt to get Metal Queen back in his arms?
That's how I'd do it.
Primetime action, let's go.
With the following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the TWA Primetime Championship. Introducing first, the challenger, accompanied by Officer Mallory, from the pit, weighing in at 271 pounds.
Oh, you got your elder accompanying you for this, Mac?
I think this is an insurance policy, if you will, Mark. I think Rich Uncle Pennybags wants to make sure that any and all momentum goes to his team at the Super Series. That Bane pulling off the victory over Dracula and winning the Primetime Championship will add a huge feather in Pennybags' cap for his team. We'll see if the champ can fight the odds.
And his opponent, from Transylvania, weighing in at 228 pounds, he is the TWA Primetime Champion, Count Dracula!
Well, Dracula's not going to be doing the Dance of Love here tonight, but the Dance of Combat, as he threatened earlier on tonight. I just hope he is able to be aware of not only his opponent Bane, but also the man who stands on the outside. That piece of shit there, Officer Mallory. Retail Robinson holding up the belt. I think Mallory and Pennybags are more fixated on that than Bane is. By the way, I couldn't help but notice earlier on in the night when Pennybags was introducing his team, he didn't introduce Batman with the same fervor or the same demeanor that he introduced Bane and Officer Mallory.
Well, he seems to have been showing more favoritism to Bane.
It's been no secret that Batman's been a bit disgruntled after being put in a light heavyweight title battle royal, which he didn't want to go for that championship. He feels he should be going for the top prize, the TWA title. I don't know if this will affect the team at all, the Super Series. Batman and Bane did show what they could do as a team when they dismantled Django and Machete a few Battlefronts ago. Bane with a hard knee to Dracula's face. Bane is very smash mouth, in your face, take no prisoners, whereas Dracula is an elite strategist. He's a unique in-ring psychologist. He knows the ins and outs of his opponents, their weaknesses, their strengths. He was able to incorporate his strategies against the former champion, Frankenstein, and beat him for the title. Of course, Dracula came out to the aid of his former foe, former friend Frankenstein, in fending off the slashers.
Where is this elite strategy that he always incorporates? He's getting destroyed.
Dracula still staying in the game. Bane's going to need to have to do a lot more if he hopes to win the primetime title here at the Jobbing.com Arena in Phoenix, Arizona. But despite the name of the arena, Bane looks like anything but a jobber right now.
Yeah, that's what Dracula looks like.
Even though this arena is witness, the Chimera Lock. Dracula hopes to finish Bane off right now, but no dice. Even though this arena is home to quite possibly the worst team in the NHL, the Arizona Coyotes, you can't say we're not giving them a great show here. One, two, no! Oh, very close. Bane was just 2¾ away from becoming the new primetime champion. And a hard hit. And once again, that must be the sign that Dracula has been busted open. He is bleeding. But of course, Pennybags has reversed any blood out of her.
You won't be able to keep that up past Super Series. We're gonna end your PG shit.
Just one thing, Mark. Will you be at ringside to accompany Alexander Ace Adams, James Bond, and Fox McCloud when they go to war against Pennybags' henchmen?
I can't. Managers aren't allowed at ringside for the Super Series tag match.
Despite bleeding, Dracula is still alive and kicking, but I don't know for how long. Bane with the Kimura driver. One, two, three, and just like that, Dracula's primetime title reign ends.
Winner of this bout and new primetime champion, Bane.
Well, I would have to consider this one an upset. Now that Bane has the prestigious primetime championship around his waist, Team Monopoly looks pretty much unstoppable heading into the Super Series.
Are you poofing your pants yet, Team whatever you're called? You know, I'll be the first to admit, I am no wrestler. But I'm not worried. I got this monster fighting alongside me. What have you got? Why me with a gun named PP? A talking dog? And a disgruntled thug who thinks he is tough? Actually, let me stop and talk about that, Triple A. I had you pegged the second I saw you, kid. I've dealt with your kind in Monopoly. Punks who think that they are the shit. Big shots. You are no different. In that Super Series, boy, I'm gonna beat you down like I did all.
Hopefully AAA will shut his mouth right here.
Why are you taking time to drink a beer? Just go down there and beat them up.
AAA will captain Team Adams at the Super Series.
That's what he's calling it.
Well, I just assumed that was the name, considering we were the ones leading the guys in battle.
I never gave them a name.
And AAA comes hard with the Singapore cane to Officer Mallory. Hard shot to the head, and now the new primetime champion is gonna try AAA on for size. And there's the coma driver. He did that to Dracula. And if AAA is gonna be suffering this bad in pain, how is he gonna last in the tag team match?
Okay, thoughts, Bond. Now's your time to shine.
Oh, but here he comes right now. Fox McCloud, hard kick to Bane. And he chases Mallory and Bane away like the cowards they are. Fox McCloud able to save his team leader, AAA, from any future damage. Although, was the damage done with that devastating coma driver? Our name is Team Retribution. Oh, okay, there we go. Team Retribution it is. So, my bad, Adams. Team Retribution will take on Team Monopoly at the Super Series. Don't forget to order it on pay-per-view.
Mr. Pennybags, I want in the tournament.
I don't know, Miss Blade. You haven't been championship material in a while.
Kidding me? Putting on an undershirt wasn't good enough for you? How about I rip off my top and flash the camera? Put me in. Right now. If you hadn't have suspended Samus, I would have fought her at the Super Series. It only makes sense that I automatically qualify.
No need to worry, Miss Connor. You were the first person that I actually put on the list. As for you, Sonya, I will throw you in only if you promise not to take your top off.
Fine.
All right then. Good luck to both of you ladies.
Turn that frown upside down, my dear.
I am literally that close to beating the shit out of you.
Don't you want to hear the good news before you do something regretful?
No news from you could be good news.
There is a four diva tournament to crown a new women's champion, starting at the Super Series. I got you in.
You did?
Yep. All those long, grueling months you suffered through are about to pay off. I just wanted to make you happy, Vanessa. Like what Nazareth never did.
Is this supposed to make me just forget about him?
No. It's like I finally see a smile on that beautiful face of yours. Please believe me, Nazareth did not care for you. Only I do.
Are you this Dos Equis guy?
Hulk Hogan booked this match between us, didn't he? To make his work easier.
I am not doing this for him. It's to make you my seventh straight victim.
I wouldn't mind watching that.
You're welcome to watch, Freulein.
What makes you think you'll have the same luck with me as you did with those choppers?
Because you are a puny man like all the others. I can crush you.
Vanessa, would you join me at ringside? I would like to end this guy's streak for you.
I'll seat myself, thank you.
Prepare to lose, number 7.
Hulk Hogan ordered Gigant to go in to a match against the current Universal Champion, the most interesting man in the world. And like I said, Gigant's challenges are not getting any easier. He was able to overthrow two men in the Barones, but how is he going to deal with a guy who recently won the Universal title?
Is she going to sit with us? Oh, please sit on my side. Please sit on my side.
Don't push your luck, Adams. Metal Queen is only out here basically to watch the most interesting man be pummeled into oblivion by Gigant.
Although I've got to ask, why is she watching this? Why should she care about this?
Humor, I guess. But anyway, let's welcome former TWA Women's Champion Metal Queen.
Oh god damn it, why do they always sit on your side?
It's much easier.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Munich, Germany, weighing in at 376 pounds, Gigant!
Gigant, currently 6-0 in the Television Wrestling Association. He hopes to make most interesting man victim number 7. Easier said than done, though. Most interesting man's unusual victory over Nazareth to win the title at Halloween Haunt. Something tells me most interesting man is going to be a guy who has a few tricks up his sleeve.
Metal Queen, you look very nice tonight. Did Most Interesting Man or Nazareth tell you that?
Will you be serious? I'm not here to do much. I'm here to watch the most interesting man finally get his face pounded to the mat by that gigantic man over there, Gigant.
His opponent, from wherever he wants, weighing in at 221 pounds,
He never says anything tastes like chicken, even chicken. He is the current TWA Universal Champion. He is the most interesting man in the world.
Jesus Christ. Is that announcer part of the Most Interesting Man's fan club?
Might as well.
I'm part of your fan club.
That's pretty evident, Alex.
Well, I appreciate the sentiment, Mark. However, I got here with sheer guts, sheer determination. I came into TWA to be the absolute best at what I do. And I also have to thank the people for still believing in me and still believing that I am the uncrowned women's champion. And I will prove to all those three other pretenders called divas that I will win the TWA Women's Championship and become champion for the third time.
You're gonna make history, you know. The only person to win a title three times.
Of course, though, Sarah Connor is also waiting in the wings, and she too is a two-time women's champion. What if she ends up beating you to the punch by chance and emerging as a three-time women's champion? Well, that bitch usually has a lot of tricks up her sleeve, RJ, but I am confident that I can beat Sarah Connor.
Meanwhile, Gigant, not dressed in his usual attire, this was an impromptu match. Gigant had to make it back in the building quickly to show up for this match as he was ordering Bulk Hogan a pizza.
That reminds me, would you like anything to eat, Metal Queen? I'll go straight to the back and get it for you.
I don't think she wants any pizza, Adams. She's gotta watch her figure.
She doesn't want anything, food, drink, a cookie.
What? Most interesting man, really giving Gigant a hard time in that ring.
Oh, the most interesting man, trust me, he only thinks he's got the better of Gigant, but once the power moves come in, it's sayonara.
Also, Metal Queen, I gotta ask, considering Nazareth's series of unfortunate events where he got not only a heart punch at the hands of the most interesting man in the world, but ended up having to go to the hospital, have you gotten any update on Nazareth's medical condition?
None so far. I just keep praying for Nazareth night and day in the hopes that he's all right. And rest assured that Nazareth will come back and he will become not only Universal Champion again, but will still be twice the man that the most interesting man in the world could never be.
Strong words.
And most interesting man just knocked out referee Charles Robinson, and
Gigant going for the arm, and he knocks most interesting man down. And it looks like, I think, do we have a disqualification? Oh, maybe not. Maybe it was unintentional, but just a thought, Metal Queen. What if you actually stepped into the ring against the most interesting man in the world?
Oh, I'd crush him.
The man is all mouth and no backing it up in the ring. And speaking of all mouth and no backing it up in the ring, all those divas in the back who think that they're going to emerge as the women's champion, especially my sworn nemesis, Sarah Connor, they think they're going to walk out with the women's title. I don't think so. I will emerge the new women's champion by end of days and close out the end of the year as the champion. And I can take that to the bank.
Yeah, just like how you opened it as the women's champion.
With a hard clothesline to the most interesting man. And now he sends the most interesting man down hard with a choke slam. Could only be a matter of time before the most interesting man becomes the most interesting seventh victim of Gigant. And there's a one. Most interesting man still getting the shoulder up.
Most interesting man is going upon stupidity and instinct more than anything else. He thinks he's going to last in the ring with Gigant.
One, two, no!
I think that was the first person to ever kick out of the consequence.
Indeed, most interesting man, he looks like he has done his homework against in scouting this German giant. The road seems to be getting harder for Gigant, and he just throws most interesting man over the ropes. This match is much more evenly paced and more competitive than Gigant's previous opponents. There's a side suplex and a hard clothesline. And there's a blatant choke. Gigant's back in the ring, daring the most interesting man to get up, but he's all dizzy. And most interesting man with a hard clothesline. Gigant shoves him off. Here's a hard Irish whip.
If I know Gigant, he is not through yet.
And now Gigant, is it the consequence again? Oh no, a shoulder breaker. And now once again, another blatant choke. This is probably one of the longer matches that Gigant has had so far. Sorry to say this, Metal Queen, but what if Most Interesting Man actually becomes the one to end the streak?
Oh, that man will become impossible if he happens to end the streak, which I doubt he will. And let me tell you something. I didn't need the Most Interesting Man to get a match for me for the women's title. I can easily get it done on my own. I can go right up to Wrench Uncle Pennybags and threaten that little snot right in the face and tell him I deserve a shot.
I wonder if Bulk Hogan made the same thing when... And wait a minute, one, two, oh, very close. As I said, I wonder if Bulk Hogan did the same thing in terms of threatening in wanting to go for a title shot against the most interesting man. But
wait a minute, we saw that footage last Battlefront. He begged for it.
As a matter of fact, we could have seen Gigant versus the most interesting man for the Universal title, possibly at the Super Series. Now here's the pin. One, two, no! Gigant is still alive. And there's the most interesting finisher in the world. Oh, this could be it. What if this is 6-1? One, two, no! Oh, my God. 2¾ away from ending the streak. One.
Oh, now most interesting man is just getting desperate now.
And Gigant is coming back up. And there's the consequence three times.
There it is. I knew we'd see it someday.
Most interesting man is out. One, two, three. Gigant has nailed his seventh victim.
Here's your winner, Gigant.
Oh, forget Hogan. Just give him the match.
Gigant pulls off his best victory yet over the reigning Universal Champion and the most interesting man in the world. And now, here comes Bulk Hogan. And Metal Queen has left the scene. I'd like to thank her for being with us while she was here for the short time being. And Bulk Hogan sits down hard on the most interesting man. Of course, he's been incapacitated. And there's... Are we going to see the leg drop of doom? There we... Oh. Well, Bulk Hogan was able to nail the most interesting man with his leg drop of doom, but that was because most interesting man just got incapacitated after a long match with Gigant. How is Bulk Hogan going to fare against a healthy Most Interesting Man for the Universal title at the Super Series? That's what I'd like to know.
Hello, Clark. What is it?
Despite how furious I am at you for what you did to Samus, I am here on business-related terms. I feel all of my personal issues have finally been resolved, sir. I would now like to resign my contract and return to full-time competition. I could start as soon as you need me to.
Oh. You didn't retire?
Retire? Why would you think that?
Well, you haven't competed full-time in over a year. And...
How can I say this?
You're irrelevant, Clark. You are a former main eventer who hasn't held a title in well over 2 years. I'm afraid... The fans just don't care about you anymore.
I'm curious, Pennybags. Do you even know what your fans want? Last time I checked, I still have legions of fans around the world. Most of them kids who are waiting for me to return and fight for them. It's not just my absence, isn't it? There's another reason that you don't want me to return. I think it has something to do with the color green.
I am not spending my money to promote a has-been like you! You are not returning full-time!
The nerve of the man forcing Superman not to come back and perform in front of his adoring fans? How does Pennybags have the right to determine who fights in the ring and who doesn't?
I'm glad I ran into you. I understand you have a big bone to pick with Freddy, but here's this. I have an even bigger bone to pick with him, and I do intend on being the one to end his title reign. And if I have to get through you tonight to receive it, then I will not hold anything back, Jason. See you out there.
Alright folks, here we are, our main event for the night. Number one contendership match, Invisible Man versus Jason Voorhees. Both men have been hungry to get their hands on the TWA World Champion Freddy Krueger. But only one of them can face Freddy for the title at our End of Days pay-per-view in December. Who will it be?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, weighing in at 210 pounds, the Invisible Man.
We were talking to Metal Queen earlier about the first person to become a three-time champion. That's him right there.
Well, provided he gets through Jason Voorhees, and also I think it's been made clear by TWA executives that this will be Invisible Man's third shot at the title. And if he loses against Jason Voorhees, let alone loses to Freddy Krueger in the title match at End of Days, this will be Invisible Man's last shot at the TWA title.
Oh, how is that fair? He wins the Royal Rumble this year, and that's the treatment he gets?
And his opponent, from Camp Crystal Lake, weighing in at 275 pounds, Jason Voorhees!
Does this match really even need to happen? Like, shouldn't Jason be retired by now? He's been here since the beginning.
Jason, much like the Invisible Man, has a bone to pick with Freddy Krueger. These two have a huge rivalry going back to the early days of the Television Wrestling Association when we were televised. These two fought tooth and nail over the original TWA Championship before it was merged. Their legendary rivalry was what put TWA on the map. And Jason still has unfinished business with the Nightmare from Elm Street.
Well, Invisible Man, just do your thing. Outsmart him like you've done so many other people.
Invisible Man relies heavily on strategy. Jason relies on power. Of course, Invisible Man will probably get him some of Freddy Krueger when they lead opposing teams at the Super Series. And provided he wins here, he may get two shots at nailing Freddy Krueger. Of course, Jason Voorhees is still waiting in the wings. Being one of the very first TWA World Champions of the promotion. Jason just knocks Invisible Man down hard. Jason is just going on basically blind luck in nailing Invisible Man whenever he can. Going for whatever he can see or whatever he can't see. Of course, Invisible Man has been in the ring with giants before. Therefore, he is not intimidated by Jason whatsoever. We've got a hell of a Super Series card lined up with all the events we've seen here tonight. It's only going to get even more intense. Jason just wailing on the Invisible Man. Jason was wailing on the Invisible Man like a father abusing a child. Of course, I wouldn't be surprised if Freddy Krueger comes out and tries to incapacitate both men, so that way he doesn't have to face either of these individuals. He's probably enjoying this right now, watching these two beat the living hell out of each other. These two are so evenly matched right now, it's hard to tell who is going to walk out of this match as the number one contender. Then again, maybe Freddy Krueger will have his slashers come out and do the deed of nailing both of these men. Jason nails the Invisible Man hard into the ring post. These two both get counted out. What's going to happen with the number one contendership?
The referee's legs always manage to get in the way of our shots.
Well, we just seem to have bad camera angles from time to time. Remember the monkeys that owned the TWAR with their camera ability? Invisible Man with unique display of strength slamming Jason Voorhees hard into the ground. But he pays the price for that maneuver. Jason with a hard elbow. Invisible Man, you never know when he's truly down and out because he usually comes back with a flurry of offense.
Who knew Jason could reverse so much?
Jason is just on fire. He really wants Freddy so bad for that title. But Invisible Man is proving not to be an easy guy to beat. One, two, no. Close. Invisible Man attempted to DDT, but Jason Voorhees stopped him dead in his tracks. Momentum is just continuing to shift between these two men. One slugs, the other hits back. Just when we thought Jason had the power in his favor, Invisible Man brings it all back with a power slam. I guess both men are looking at each other like they're, like it's Freddy Krueger in that ring. And that's what's bringing out the best, or the worst, depending on your viewpoint, out of these men.
Just hit your hollow slam and be done with it, please. Well, that's the setup for it. Come on.
Invisible Man, though, is going for the pin, which... Is he going to do it right here? Here it is, the hollow slam. This is what catapulted him to the TWA title twice.
What are you waiting for?
Here's the pin. One, two, no! Jason Voorhees is still alive! Jason with a snapmare. Invisible Man, he's now reversing Jason's power as a weakness. And I think that was a curb stomp by the Invisible Man. Hard power slam to the ground. Invisible Man going for the airplane spin, and the crowd in Phoenix is going nuts. Oh, and Jason just reversed the snap suplex in his favor. Here's the pin. One. Invisible Man still showing life yet. I don't think either one of these individuals is going to throw in the towel anytime soon. And now... Invisible Man scouting him with an Irish whip. Jason Voorhees hanging on the ropes, literally. Invisible Man just bringing the pain. Invisible Man was always a shrewd strategist, but I didn't know he could be powerful and angry in that ring. He has an innate mean streak.
Oh, I can't take this anymore. Why isn't Frankenstein or Chorus coming to help?
Jason, hard kick. And a Russian leg sweep by Invisible Man. Invisible Man, what does he have to do to keep Jason Voorhees down for a long period of time? Because he hasn't figured it out. At this rate, you have to wonder if Invisible Man is going to be at 100% capacity come the Super Series. Freddy Krueger is probably laughing at the idea that he's going to walk all over the Invisible Man in the tag match.
Oh, it's almost over, thank God.
Invisible Man bringing him to the center of the ring. He goes for that near pinfall just before he goes for that hollow slam. Oh! Jason with a hard shot! That will put a second guess to executing a hollow slam or anything for that matter. One, two, oh, close. Jason, just with that hard choke slam, but Invisible Man is still alive and kicking. He wants that title match just as bad as Jason wants it.
Oh, get out of the ring. Get out of the ring.
Now we're going to see the Camp Crystal Lake cross. And, oh, halfway across the ring. Invisible Man is probably down and out. One, two, three. Jason is the number one contender.
Here is your winner, Jason Voorhees.
And now the Slasher's coming in and beating up Jason Voorhees. And now also attacking Invisible Man while he's down and out, picking the bones like the cowards that they are. Oh, and here comes the biggest coward of all, Freddy Krueger. Now, wait a minute. Carlos and Frankenstein come to the aid of their leader. And now Frankenstein helps Invisible Man to his knees, but lights went out again. There's that mysterious snow that's been plaguing our arenas for the past couple of weeks. Are we gonna finally find out what this is all about?
Wait! That's it! I'm getting annoyed by this snow! Is this you, Freddy? Is this some newcomer trying to get my attention? Let me tell you this, you nuisance. I just lost my last chance to win back my title. I am in no mood for this crap. And if you do this to me again at Super Series, I promise I will find you and give you a piece of my mind.
Stern warning from Invisible Man to whoever this person releasing the snow is. And I would also deliver that as a stern warning to Freddy and the Slashers, who will take on Invisible Man and his team of monsters at the Super Series. Don't forget to order it live on pay-per-view. But thanks for joining us on Battlefront in Phoenix, Arizona, everybody. RJ Peckham and Mark Adams signing off.